Hi friends, welcome to another video. Today we are going to be talking about logics aside, pay transparency can be a pretty sensitive topic, especially for those in the environmental industry, those who struggle to negotiate their salaries, or anyone who might be more prone to lower salary offerings. So I just wanted to talk about the importance of pay transparency within the environmental space and a tool that I use to make sure that I know I'm getting paid fairly. Hopefully it will help you also get paid fairly and give you the confidence you need to negotiate your salary and get it to the level that you want it to be. Now, 2 years ago, when I was applying to environmental jobs in the DC metro area, I was sent this form called Environmental Jobs Salary Transparency. Essentially, what the form is a way for anyone who is working in the environmental industry to list what organization they work for, their position title, their sector, years of experience, and then their base salary and hourly rate. There's also options for them to enter in bonuses and other benefits, as well as their location. I cannot take credit for this form at all. It was started by the Women in Technology Transparency Movement, and it was created with the idea that pay equity is one of the first steps in ensuring equal representation of all genders, races, and ethnicities in the environmental field. The ultimate goal is to provide concrete data and information for everyone to use in their salary and raise negotiations. Because being armed with the knowledge of what others in your type of role are getting paid will hopefully give you the confidence that you need when you are negotiating for a higher pay. And the more data we have, the more power we have in those salary and raise negotiations. And that's kind of why I wanted to make this video and just get this form and spreadsheet out there so that if you are working in the environmental field, you can click on the link in the description and go fill it out so that others can know what to expect if they're looking for a job like yours. What does this actual spreadsheet look like? We are going to walk through it together. I have my laptop right in front of me. So essentially, these are all of the questions from the form that others have filled out. Currently, it looks like there are over 500 entries. That is so much data, you guys, and you can filter by organization name, position title, you name it. You start with the organization name, and there's some examples here. I think it's filtered alphabetically. We also have position title, and they do range from the very bottom of the totem pole, from like analyst all the way to, you know, director of strategy. We have senior managers on there. We have educators, so many different types of roles, HRVP, analyst. This is crazy, you guys. Environmental scientist and project manager, conservation geneticist and laboratories manager. So many different and very interesting roles, in my opinion. They also on the form can give a brief description of what their role does. So I've mentioned this in previous videos, but oftentimes the actual title that you're given explains absolutely nothing about your role. So for example, for ABT Associates, this analyst, that doesn't describe anything about what they do. So they say that they are a contractor for the US EPA in the chemicals space, and that gives them a little more information about what they're actually doing on the day-to-day. They can then go into the sector that they work in. So for this one, it would be private and consulting, but they can also enter in things like nonprofits, private business, etc. Now, this category I think is very important. It's the year that they were offered that salary, and I think it's important because obviously with inflation, the salary offerings will change based on the year. So if you are still getting offered by this company the same amount that someone was getting offered in 2018, that is a red flag, and you do not want to work for that company because they obviously aren't adjusting their salaries for inflation. So after we see the year that they were offered that salary, we actually see the base salary, and you can either enter it in annual salary or hourly rate along with any bonuses that you get at any point in the year. People also will list out other benefits that they get. And these are, I think, really important to take into consideration. Everyone has different priorities in life and everyone's at different stages in their life. So after you fill in the base salary, bonus, and other benefits, you can enter in your total compensation. Honestly, not a lot of people have entered this in just because it is kind of hard to calculate based on all of that. I do think it's important to keep in mind here that the salary does not tell the whole story. And hopefully by filling out these other categories, we can get a better idea of that whole story. Next, we go to location of the organization, because obviously pay will change based on where you are and the cost of living in that area. The company size as well, days of paid time off per year, number of years of experience at the organization, and number of years of experience in the environmental field, and total number of years of experience. So these three categories will help you get an idea of how you compare to the person who filled out that form originally. We also have, for similar reasons, the highest education level and any advanced degrees and where they got them. We also include gender identity, race, and any other comments. And this is really so we can identify any biases in those companies and really watch out for any particular biases, whether they are based on gender, race, or ethnicity. I think that is one of the most valuable things of this spreadsheet, is we can identify and hold accountable the companies that are not paying its employees equally based on those parameters. So again, I think this form and this spreadsheet is incredible. I don't know who made it still, whoever made it, thank you. You're doing so much good for the environmental field, and you helped me out personally. So if the universe aligns and you see this, please reach out, because I'm very grateful for you for making this. And if you work in the environmental field, I would encourage you to fill out the form that's linked, just so other environmental professionals can get a better idea of what everyone is getting paid in the industry. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more like it, hit that subscribe button below, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.